talk about the idea behind the project?
Yeah. Sure.
Okay. Yes.
So I grew up in New York and I went to grad school at Cranbrook, and I knew I didn't want to go back to New York right away because I was making big installations and it didn't make any sense. So someone told me to apply the core program. It was the most amazing experience to come down here. It was very tropical, fish tacos. It was amazing. But then September 11th happened and then things shifted. But I think the biggest thing I noticed being down here was driving on the freeway. I mean, you see billboards in New York, and of course they're there, but they have a weight to them that they don't. That they have a weight to them that they don't have here. I mean, they have the same weight and feeling that the buildings do and the way the people do. So you're kind of aware of their power and what they can represent and what they mean and what they allow to happen. And here I found myself like driving on the freeway, and all I saw was sky and these billboards. And 45, I avoided at all costs, even though that's David's favorite freeway. I avoided, like, I just couldn't handle it. Like, it made me, other than the traffic and all that, it was too claustrophobic and all those signs. But there was something about being on 59 that they were there, but they seemed to allow for something else. So I did a project at the Victoria Museum. It's like a Take 59, South Hill doesn't go anywhere. It's this town in Victoria, Texas. And I did a project there where I photographed signs, like Exxon sign or Jack in the Box. And I kind of wanted to make them characters, make them have the weight of what they can do to us. So I photographed them with all these different skies, like the Waffle House and the Blue Storm. And I mounted them on thick plexiglass. It was my attempt to like make them matter. And then after that, I did this project at Project Row Houses. I don't know if you guys ever noticed that billboard structure there. I got a brand new catch, which is not called Catch anymore. So I guess that was an area where, I mean, that area is a predominantly, I know it's being gentrified and shifting, but it was an area that's a predominantly black, lower class neighborhood, and I kept thinking about it reminding me of parts of Brooklyn where advertising in those areas are often detrimental to the community, be it liquor, fast food, things that we don't need, cigarettes. And I was thinking, well, maybe a billboard could do something else. Maybe it could celebrate the people who are there. So I used to hang out at that park because I was kind of involved in Project Row Houses. And there were these three guys, or two of them, used to hang out there all the time. So I asked them, can I just take a picture of them? And I wanted to put a billboard, a photograph of them, kind of the place where I put it in. I think the idea was maybe a billboard ad could be about celebrating people and celebrating the community. But I also kept thinking about maybe it could be a way of another vehicle, as opposed to it being just about commerce and services. Maybe it could be a way of talking about community and making sure that we don't lose sight of community. So I remember the night I was installing it, I worked with, David Gravy. And it was a horrible install because we were having a hard time making the vinyl not wrinkle. It was like 5 in the morning. And I remember this guy comes up to me and he says, "Oh my God, that's Big Will. He always has that sad look in his eyes. Al, he always like has that smirk on his face." And I thought it was amazing that this guy kind of captured, like, somehow in this like quick photo, I was able to capture the personalities of these people, and it was doing exactly what I wanted.